开始了。哎，先这节课是大内克里还是图西哥皮纳里？
Hi, Krishna.
啊，是你啊，好。
Okay. You're ready to see Gopinath?
Yes.
Okay. Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Pastaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Jai Jai Shri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Tandra, Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Tandra, Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
So we're speaking from the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Lila, Lord Chaitanya's pastimes.
我们正在讲述的是《Chaitanya Charitamrita》中篇逍遥，主Chaitanya马哈法布的逍遥时光。
And we were hearing how Lord Chaitanya traveled around South India, and then he came back to Jagannath Puri.
我们已经聆听到了主Chaitanya马哈法布结束了他的南印度之旅，回到了Jagannath Puri。
So when Lord Chaitanya came back to Jagannath Puri, devotees were very happy to see him. And we were hearing about the King of Puri, Maharaj Prataparudra, how he wanted to meet Lord Chaitanya.
我们也聆听到了Puri的国王Maharaj Prataparudra国王，他十分想见到主Chaitanya。But
Lord Chaitanya didn't want to meet him because he thought it's not good. He's a materialistic person.
然而主Chaitanya马哈法布并不想会面这位国王，因为他觉得这位国王是一位物质主义者，所以这样的会面是不好的。
Because kings are always involved in politics and they have a lot of business, their business is politics and sense gratification. But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya told Lord Chaitanya, this king is a very good devotee.
然而呢，扎瓦邦马把他差呀，告诉主凯潘呀，这位国王是一名很好的奉献者。And
then Ramananda Rai also came, and he came with the king to Jagannath Puri.
然后这个 Ramananda Rai 和国王一起也回到了 Jagannath Puri.
And Ramananda Rai came to meet Lord Chaitanya, And he told Lord Chaitanya about the king, that he is a very good devotee.
Ramananda Loi 呢就来到 Puri 见到了主 Chaitanya， 他向主 Chaitanya 讲述了这个国王其实是一位很好的奉献者。
Now Ramananda Rai, he was working for the king. He was in charge of some of the king's land, taking care of some of the kingdom.
这个 Ramananda Rai 就解释说，他之前是在为这个国王工作的，他就是为这个国王负责管理一片土地。
Yeah, the king had a big kingdom.A lot of land, and so he had different men in charge of different areas. And Ramananda Rai was in charge of the area in the south. So when Lord Chaitanya met Ramananda Rai, he told Ramananda Rai, give up this job and you come back and stay with me in Jagannath Puri. So Ramananda Rai told the king he wanted to give up his job and stay in Jagannath Puri to be with Lord Chaitanya. So what did the king say? Who knows what the king said?
是怎么回答的呢？谁知道国王是如何反应的呢？
国王非常非常的高兴，就同意了，而且还给他了一大笔退休金。Hare Krishna。
Yes, thank you. It's a good boss, huh? If you get a boss like that, you're very lucky.
这位国王是一位很好的老板，如果我们得到这样的老板的话，是很幸运的。
So, Ramananda Rai came and told Lord Chaitanya how the king had been so kind to him.
所以这个 Ramananda Rai 呢，就告诉主 Chaitanya 这位国王对他是多么的仁慈。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard,how the king had been so kind to Ramananda Rai, he said to Ramananda Rai, he said, because the king has been kind to you, so Krishna will be kind to him.
所以主 Krishna 也一定会把他的仁慈给予这位国王的。
Yeah, somebody who is a devotee of Krishna must also be kind to Krishna's devotees.
嗯，sorry, Maharaj.
A devotee of Krishna will also be kind to Krishna's devotees.
如果一名奉献如果是一名主 Krishna 的奉献者的话，那他也一定对 Krishna 的这些其他的奉献者十分的友好。
Of course, you get some people, they're called Kanishta Adhikari. They think God is only in the deity.
当然了，有一些人呢，有一些奉献者呢是 Kanishta Adhikari。这些奉献者只能够在神像中见到主 Krishna.
They don't see Krishna in the heart of other people.
他们没有看到主 Krishna 也在其他人的心中。
So, Krishna said, if somebody is my devotee, they're not really my devotee. But if they're a devotee of my devotee, then the devotees, the real devotees.
所以 Krishna 就说呢，那些宣称，是我的奉献者的人，其实并不是我的奉献者，而那些是我的奉献者的奉献者的人，才真正是我的奉献者。
嗯。So a devotee not only worships Krishna, they also worship Krishna's devotees.
所以奉献者们，不仅仅崇拜主 Krishna, 而且也崇拜 Krishna 的奉献者。
There's a famous verse spoken by Lord Shiva to his wife.
Shiva 向他的妻子讲出了一个非常著名的诗节。
Aradhanam sarvesham Vishnor aradhanam param tasmat tarataram devi tadiyanam samacharam. Lord Shiva told his wife that of all kinds of worship, the worship of Vishnu is the best.
主希瓦告诉他的妻子，在所有的崇拜当中，对主维什纳的崇拜是最高的。
But even better than the worship of Vishnu is to worship those things in relation to Vishnu.
然而，比崇拜主维什纳更好的是崇拜那些与维什纳有关的事物。
Just like we also worship Tulsi.
就比如我们也崇拜朱熹女神。
And we also worship Prabhupada.
我们也崇拜舍勒帕帕。
And we worship also Mother Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj.
我们也崇拜亚洲大母亲和 Nanda Maharaj.
We worship all the things in relation to Krishna.
我们会崇拜所有与 Krishna 相关的人和物。
So, pure devotees worship Krishna. Krishna is the supreme of all the demigods.
所以奉献者们嘛，请崇拜主 Krishna. Krishna 是所有半神人之主。
And he is also the controller of all the living entities.
他也是所有生物体的控制者。
So we worship Krishna, but we also worship Krishna's devotees.
所以我们崇拜 Krishna, 也崇拜 Krishna 的奉献者们。
We have to respect the devotees.
我们向奉献者们致以敬意。
So Ramananda Rai offered obeisances to all the devotees. There were many devotees present.
所以呢 ，Ramananda Rai 就向奉献者们致以他的顶拜。当时有很多奉献者们在场。
There were four sannyasis, so Ramananda Rai offered obeisances to all four sannyasis.
在场的呢有四位萨尼阿喜，所以 Ramananda Roy 向这四位萨尼阿喜致以顶拜。
There was Paramananda Puri, Brahmananda Bharati, Swarupa Damodara, and Lord Nityananda.
这四位萨尼阿喜是 Paramananda Puri.Brahmananda Bharati, Swarup Damodar, and Lord Nityananda.
So, Ramananda Rai showed his respect for all of them.
Ramananda Rai 向他们所有人都表达了他的敬意。
So Lord Chaitanya asked him, asked Ramananda Rai, did you go to see Lord Jagannath yet?
主 Chaitanya 就问 Ramananda Rai,你是否已经拜访过主加特纳的
？Ramananda Rai said, "No, I'm going to go now."
Ramananda Rai 回答说，我现在正要去。
So Lord Chaitanya said, why have you done like that? You should go first to see Lord Jagannath and then come here.
你为什么那么做呢？你应该首先去见主加格纳，然后再到我这里来。
Why did you come to see me first?
你为什么先到我这里来了呢？
So Ramananda Rai says, well, my heart brought me here.
Ramananda Rai 回答说，是我的心把我带到了这里。
I was attracted to come and see you. And then I'll go and see Lord Jagannath.
所以呢，我的心把我带到了这里，我就先来见你了。之后我会去见主加格纳。Right.
Some people, they follow rules and regulations like this, that you should go first to go and see the deity, and then you go and see others.
就是一般的规范原则，就是我们要先去见这个神像，然后再去见其他人。
But Ramananda Rai said, my mind brought me here. I wanted to see you. I didn't think about going to see Jagannath first.
但是呢，Ramananda Rai却说呢，我是我的心，把我带到这里，所以我先来见你。 我甚至没有想着要先去见主加格纳。So
that was Ramananda Rai acting on the basis of love.
就是因为 Ramananda Rai 他出于这个爱所做出的行为。So
Lord Chaitanya told him, he said, now you go and see Lord Jagannath, and then you go home and see your family members.
然后主查泰马法布就说道：“你现在去见主扎格纳，然后呢，你回家去见你的家人。”So
Ramananda Rai went to temple, and then he went home.
所以 Ramananda Rai 呢，就去了这个主扎格纳的庙，然后呢，他就回到了他自己的家。So
the king had come to Jagannath Puri, so he called for Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, because Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is like the guru of the king, and he's in charge of the temple. So the king offered him obeisances and then asked him, he said, did you speak to Lord Chaitanya about my desire to meet him? So Sarvabhauma said, yes, I tried. But still the Lord would not agree to see a king. And he said, if I ask him again about meeting you, he would leave Jagannath Puri and go some other place. So the king was very unhappy to hear this, and he said, just see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to deliver the fallen souls.
当国王听说这些的时候呢，他感到非常不高兴，然后他就说了一番话。
He's come to deliver all the sinful, low-born people. He even delivered people like Jagai and Madhai.
He
So has he come in this world just to deliver all kinds of sinful people except for me, except for a king named Maharaj Prataparudra? Of course, Lord Chaitanya came to deliver the fallen souls. When we are greeting Panchatattva in Mayapur every day, we sing the song Patita Pavana Hetu Tava Avatara Mosamo Patita Prabhu Napaebi Ara. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the most merciful. He's come to deliver the fallen souls.
Patita Pavana Hetu Tava Avatara Mosama Patita Pabu Napai Veara. Yutadama Pabu to the way and Sita Tajanin Joshua Wellington Yodolo the Nipun.
So Maharaj Prataparudra is very humble. He considers himself to be very fallen.
So Yuga Patapa Rudra Maharaj Tafetan the Tienbe Abazi Shiwe Shiga Dolo the Nipun.
But the more fallen a person is, the more he has a right to, he's more qualified to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. So Lord Chaitanya cannot really refuse him. Cannot just say, oh no, I don't want to give mercy to a materialistic person. So the king says, it seems like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to deliver everyone except for me. He gives his mercy to all kinds of low-class people who are, you know, who are impure, who are contaminated, but why he doesn't want to see me? So Maharaj Prataparudra said, if Lord Chaitanya is not going to see me, then I will give up my life. I might as well just give up my life. So this is the determination of Maharaj Prataparudra. If we want to advance or progress in Krishna consciousness, we also have to be very determined.
如果我们想要在 Krishna 知觉当中取得进步，我们也要有很大的决心。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna uses the word dridavrat. Dridavrat means very determined. You do something, you make a vow with great determination.
这个在《博伽梵歌》当中，主 Krishna 用了一个词叫 dridavrat。这个词的意思就是十分。
Krishna is describing the Mahatma. He said the Mahatmas, they endeavor with great determination, bowing before me, chanting my name.
Krishna 他就描述了伟大的灵魂嘛，他的嘛，这些伟大的灵魂以极大的决心崇拜我，向我致以敬拜。
Satatam kirtayanto mam yatantascha dridavrata namashyantascha mam bhaktya nitya yukta upasate. Right, this is the verse that, in chapter 9, text 14. That a devotee, a serious devotee, must be very determined to do Krishna consciousness. And we will see, because the king was so determined that finally he was able to get Lord Chaitanya's mercy.
而且呢，你们也会看到，因为这位国王他把如果他非常的有决心，所以最终他一定会得到主坦坦亚的仁慈。
The king even said, he tells Sarvabhauma, if I don't get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, he said, my kingdom and my body are useless. I give up everything.
这位国王呢，甚至对沙瓦宝马巴塔塔亚说道：“如果我不能够得到主台坦亚的仁慈的话，那我的生命和我的王国都是毫无用处的。我会放弃所有这些，我会放弃我的生命。”
In Bhagavad Gita, in the purport, Krishna, Lord Srila Prabhupada gives us another example about determination.
在《薄伽梵歌》当中，说到他把举出了另外一个例子来讲述这个决心。
Anybody know?
有谁知道呢
？Who is reading Bhagavad Gita?
谁阅读了《薄伽梵歌》？
小麻雀的故事。
Oh, very good. Yes, very good. 谁回答 ？Krishna Balaram。
Krishna
Balaram
Das 回答。
Yeah.
对，小麻雀。
Yeah.
小麻雀的蛋掉的孩，他要把孩子，那个嘎尔的帮他把蛋拔回了他。
Yes, right. The little sparrow, his eggs got taken by the ocean, so he said, "I'm going to drink the sea dry until I get back my eggs."
这个小麻雀呢，它的蛋掉到了这个海水里，所以它就下决心说，我要把这个海水吸干，把这个蛋找回来。
And then Garuda came to help the little bird, and he told the ocean, "You give the sparrow his eggs back, or I will drink you dry."
所以当 Garuda 听说之后呢，他就来帮助这个小麻雀。他就要这个海洋把这个小麻雀的蛋还回来，如果不还回来的话，他就要把这个海水吸干。
And so determination is a very important quality in Krishna consciousness.
所以这个决心在 Krishna 知觉当中是非常重要的一个品质。
So this Maharaj Prataparudra, this king,He's very determined to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. And when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya heard the king speak like that with so much determination, he was amazed. He was amazed because usually people who are involved with sense gratification are not so determined. So the king, of course, he could enjoy a lot of sense gratification. He has a big kingdom, he's very powerful, but he's very determined.
So this king, 虽然他有很多的机会， 进行感官享乐，他有这么大的一个王国，但是即便如此呢，他还是很有决心。
And we will see when he meets Lord Chaitanya, when he does get the chance to meet Lord Chaitanya, because it's arranged that he gets to give Lord Chaitanya a massage. So at that time, he's reciting Srimad Bhagavatam.
所以在之后我们会聆听到，他最终有机会，得到了这个，机会去见到这个主查泰亚马尔帕布，他也得到了一个机会为这个主查泰亚按摩，那个时候，他得到了这个主的仁慈。
So at that time he's reciting the Gopi Gita, the prayers, the song of the Gopis, which they sing when they're searching for Krishna.
在那个时候呢，这个帕塔帕日爪国王就为主查塔尼亚朗诵了这个圣典博迦瓦坛当中的这个 Gopi Gita 之歌。这个 Gopi Gita 之歌描述的就是，Gopi 们到处寻找主 Krishna。
Jayati te dikam janmana praja jay shrayata indira shasva datrahi daita drishyatam dikshitavakas twayatritasavas twamvachinvate. The king knows all the verses. There's 19 verses, and the king could sing all the verses while he's giving Lord Chaitanya massage.
这个帕塔帕日舍国王他知道这首歌的十九个诗节，他就在为这个主查塔尼亚按摩的时候为他朗诵了所有的这些诗节。
So the king was really a good devotee. He knew, he studied the philosophy, he read the scriptures, and he memorized slokas.
所以这位国王其实是一位非常好的奉献者，他知道这个哲学，他也阅读了这些经典，并且记忆了这些诗节。
So he showed he was really a good devotee, and he had a lot of determination.
所以他展示了，他真的是一位很好的奉献者，他有很大的决心。
You know, he has to take care of the kingdom, and he has more than one wife, and he has children.And he has so many politics and people to take care of, business to take care of, but still he would take time to study and memorize slokas from the Srimad Bhagavatam.
虽然这位国王呢，他要照顾整个国家，而且呢，他有多个妻子，有很多的孩子，而且呢，他要忙于这些政治事务。尽管如此呢，他还是花时间来学习和背诵圣典博迦瓦坛当中的这些诗节。
So Lord Chaitanya tells Sarvabhauma, he said, "Don't worry." Sarvabhauma tells the king. He tells the king. Sarvabhauma tells the king. He said, "Don't worry." He said, "I am sure Lord Chaitanya will give his mercy to you because you are very determined."
然后这个沙瓦邦玛巴塔恰雅就对国王说道呢，不要担心，我确信主查塔马尔帕布一定会将他的仁慈给予你的，因为你有如此坚定的决心。
So the Bhattacharya, he's the guru of the king. So he was giving the blessings that he would get the mercy of Krishna.
所以呢，这个巴塔恰雅就好比是国王的guru。所以呢，他就祝福了这位国王，他肯定会得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
By the mercy of the spiritual master, you get the mercy of Krishna.
凭借着灵性导师的仁慈，你得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
Yeah, Bhattacharya is the spiritual master, and Lord Chaitanya is Krishna.
Bhattacharya 呢，他是灵性导师，而主查塔尼亚就是 Krishna.
So.The guru is blessing him that definitely you'll get the mercy of Krishna.
所以这个 guru, 这位灵性导师就祝福了国王，他肯定会得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya told the king, he said, the Lord can only be approached by pure love.
萨瓦邦马巴塔查亚就告诉国王说，只有纯粹的奉爱，只有凭借纯粹的奉爱才能接近主。
He said, your love for Lord Chaitanya is very pure, so I'm sure without a doubt he will be kind upon you.
他说你对主柴坦雅的爱是非常纯粹的，所以我确信，主柴坦雅一定会对你仁慈。
First qualification is determination.
第一个资格，首要的资格是决心。
If you read the Upadeshamrita, Nectar of Instruction, Rupa Goswami gives 6 qualifications.
如果你阅读了这个 Upadeshamrita, 教诲的甘露的话，在这本书里面 ，Rupa Goswami 列举出了六项品质。
And he says one has to have determination.
他说到其中的一个品质就是一个人应该有决心。
And then when Krishna is pleased with our service, then we will get Krishna's mercy.
当 Krishna 被我们的服务所取悦的时候，我们就会能够得到主 Krishna 的仁慈。
Of course, we have to follow the principle of the teachings. We have to follow the instructions, the teachings of the spiritual master.
当然了，我们要追随灵性导师的教导和训示。
So then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya tells the king, there's one way in which you can directly see Lord Chaitanya.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢就给国王提出了一个建议，他说呢有一个办法可以让你直接见到主柴坦雅。
He said, when they have the Rathyatra festival,At that time, Lord Chaitanya will dance for the pleasure of Lord Jagannath.
他说到呢，在那个拉他亚场乘车节的那一天，主柴坦雅会为了主迦赞那的快乐而在这个乘车面前跳舞。
And after he dances in front of the Jagannath deity, he'll become tired and he will take some rest in the. There's a garden called the Gundicha Garden.
当主塔坦雅在这个主迦赞那神像面前跳舞之后呢，他会感到疲倦，然后他会去一个花园，名叫贡迪卡的花园去休息。
So you should go there, but don't come as a king. Come in ordinary dress.
在那个时候呢，你应该去到那里，但是呢，你不应该以一个国王的身份去那里，你应该穿着普通人的衣服。
So you go there, and at that time you can also read the 5 chapters of the Bhagavatam about Lord Krishna's pastime with the gopis.
你应该在那个时候去到那里，并且去朗读这个《圣莲婆迦瓦谈》当中。的五个章节就是关于主 Krishna 和 Gopi 们跳舞的这五个章节的内容。
So at that time you can get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
在那个时候你可以得到主柴坦雅的仁慈。
When you recite from the Srimad Bhagavatam, he will feel very happy and you will awaken his love for Krishna and he will embrace you.
在那个时候，如果你朗读《圣莲婆迦瓦谈》的这个诗节的话，主柴坦雅会感到非常的愉悦，你将唤醒他对这个主 Krishna 的爱，这样的话他就会拥抱你。
Because when he hears you reciting Srimad Bhagavatam, he'll know you're a pure Vaishnava.
因为当他聆听到了你朗诵《圣莲婆迦瓦谈》的时候，他就会确信你是一位纯粹的 Vaishnava。
So this is the plan. This is how the king can get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
这就是他们的计划，就是这位国王如何能够得到主柴坦雅的仁慈。
So the king gave this plan. The Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya gave this plan to the king.
所以呢，这个萨瓦邦马达塔查亚就向国王，描述了这个计划。
And Sarvabhauma told the king, he said, Actually, Ramananda Rai already spoke about your love for Lord Chaitanya.
这个沙沃邦玛巴那他呀，同时也说到呢，因为这个 Ramananda 诺伊已经描述了你对这个主查坦雅的这个爱。
So Lord Chaitanya had heard from both Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Ramananda Rai. They both said the king is a very good devotee and is very good. You should meet him.
所以主查坦雅呢，已经从两名奉献者那里聆听了，他从 Ram 奉献者那里听说了这位国王是一位很好的奉献者。他应该跟这个国王会面。
So Lord Chaitanya said, well, Krishna will be merciful. And one day Krishna will be merciful to the king.
所以那个巴纳萨亚就说到这个主 Krishna 有一天一定会对这个国王仁慈的。
So anybody who wants to advance in Krishna consciousness, you have to get the mercy of a devotee.
任何想在 Krishna 知觉当中取得进步的人呢，必须得到奉献者的仁慈。
So our first business is to try to satisfy spiritual teachers.
所以我们的首要职责，我们的首要任务是要去努力满足灵性导师。
And then when they're satisfied, then you get Krishna's mercy.
当灵性导师被取悦的时候，你就可以得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
Through the mercy of the devotee, we get the mercy of Krishna.
通过奉献者的仁慈，你得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
Prahlad Maharaj also teaches the same thing. You have to get the dust from the feet of the devotee to get the mercy of Krishna.
Prahlad Maharaj 也给出了同样的教导。他说到，我们首先要得到奉献者的这个。莲花足下的尘土，然后呢，你得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
So the king of Puri, he had worshipped both Ramananda Rai and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. He got blessings from both of them.
所以这位普瑞的国王帕塔巴鲁佐，他崇拜了Ramananda Rai 和 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 两个人，因此呢，他得到了他们两个人的这个仁慈。
And by their mercy, By their mercy, the king will get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
凭借着他们的仁慈呢，国王才得到了这个主台潘塔的仁慈。
So, when Bhattacharya gave all these instructions to the king took it very seriously, and he felt some happiness. He thought a bit, felt a bit more satisfied that.It's a good plan in the future. I can get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
沙瓦邦玛巴塔查亚呢就把这一番训示给予了国王。这个国王呢，他非常认真的接受了。他感到很高兴，觉得这是一个很好的计划。能够让他去得到主台潘雅的仁慈。
So.The king wanted to know when is the bathing ceremony of Lord Jagannath.
国王想知道这个主 Jagannath 的沐浴仪式在什么时候开始。
Every year, before the Rath Yatra, there will be the 15 days before, there will be the bathing ceremony of Lord Jagannath.
每一年的这个 Rath Yatra 盘车节之前的15天。有一个这个主加格纳的沐浴仪式。
So when the king asked, Bhattacharya said, "Well, there's still 3 more days. After 3 days, we will have the bath of Lord Jagannath."
这个巴达查亚就告诉国王说，你这个加格纳的沐浴仪式只有三天了，就是三天之后就开始这个沐浴仪式了。
So.When it came time for the bathing ceremony of Lord Jagannath, Lord Chaitanya was very happy.
在主加格纳的沐浴仪式那一天，主查坦雅变得非常的高兴开心。
But After the ceremony, then Lord Jagannath is taken away, and they have to paint, they repaint the Jagannath deity.
这个但是呢，在这个沐浴仪式之后呢，这个主迦格纳他就被带走了，因为这个祭司要给这个主迦格纳重新进行除秽。
It takes about 15 days to do the painting.
就是做这个涂绘需要花上15天的时间。
And then after the painting, then the deities come out and they have Rath Yatra.
就是这个涂绘完成之后呢，这个神像就会出来。
So for 15 days, you cannot see Lord Jagannath.
在这15天之内是不能够见到主迦格纳的。
So when Lord Chaitanya, after the bath, when Lord Jagannath is taken away to be painted, Lord Chaitanya became very unhappy.
对，当主迦格纳被带走，这个祭司给他们给主迦格纳进行涂绘的这段期间。
Lord Chaitanya was feeling the separation from Lord Jagannath.
主查坦雅感受到与主迦格纳的分离之情。
So it was very difficult for Lord Chaitanya. So at that time, Lord Chaitanya, every year, when they do the after the bathing of Lord Jagannath, then Lord Chaitanya will leave Jagannath Puri and he will go to a place called Alanath.
所以呢，这一段时间对于主查坦雅来说是很困难的一个时间，就是每一年当这个主迦格纳被带走进行涂绘的这个期间呢，这个主查坦雅就会离开迦格纳普里，他会去到阿那那。Lord
Chaitanya is feeling the same anxiety like the gopis when Krishna leaves them. To go to Mathura, then the gopis are in anxiety and separation from Krishna. So Lord Chaitanya was in that mood, in that feeling anxiety, Krishna's gone.
Krishna 然后这些牧牛姑娘们都处在与Krishna的这个分离之情的焦虑当中，同样的，主Chaitanya也感受到了这个，也在同样的心绪当中，也是在这种与Krishna分离的这种焦虑当中。But
when Lord Chaitanya was in Alanath, then they got news that all the devotees are coming from Bengal. All of the Vaishnavas are coming from Navadvipa and all these devotees, they're all going to come to Jagannath Puri, coming all the way from Bengal. So they told Lord Chaitanya, you have to come back to Jagannath Puri.
当这个主查坦雅在阿那那那的时候呢，就是他们就得到了一个消息，所有的奉献者们都将从这个孟加拉，从这个拉瓦追帕来到加格纳普里，所以呢，他们就去通知主查坦雅。 就告诉他，奉献者们将要从孟加拉来到普里了，于是呢，就请求他返回普里。So
Lord Chaitanya heard this, he had to come back to Puri, and so he came back to Puri, and Sarvabhauma told the king, Lord Chaitanya is also here in Puri now, he came back to Puri, so the king also comes, he wants to just be there in Jagannath Puri.
所以当主查坦雅马卡布他听说他要回布瑞的时候呢，他就回到了加格纳布瑞。与此同时呢，这个萨巴邦瓦巴达查亚他也通知了这个国王，主回到了布瑞。于是呢，这个国王也来到了这个布瑞。And
they said there are 200 devotees coming from Bengal, and they're all very advanced, and they're all very devoted to Lord Chaitanya.
他说到呢，有200名奉献者从孟加拉来，而这所有的这些奉献者们呢，都是非常进步的奉献者，都是对主查坦雅十分亲切的奉献者。We
have to arrange their accommodation. We have to arrange prasadam for all of them.
我们要为他们所有人安排住宿的地方。
The king said, I will make arrangements. I will tell all the attendants in the temple to arrange for everyone to give nice accommodation and nice prasada.
这个国王就回答说呢，我会做出这个安排，我会命令这个庙里的侍从，来为他们每一个人安排，住处的地方，还有prasada。
So the king says, he said, I want you to show me all the devotees of Lord Chaitanya. I want to see these people.
这个国王就说到呢。我想请你就是告诉我，这些前来见主查坦尼亚的奉献者。
So they get the king to go up on the roof of the palace because all the devotees are going to come past the palace, so they can be up on the roof and they can see everybody.
所以呢，这个国王就来到了他的这个宫殿的屋顶，因为。这些从孟加拉来的奉献者呢，会路过这个宫殿，所以如果国王站在这个屋顶上的话，他就能够看到这些奉献者们。
So, but Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he said, I don't know any of them. I never saw them before. But Gopinath Acharya, my brother-in-law, he knows them.
但是呢，这个 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就说到呢。我不认识这些奉献者，因为我在此之前从来没有见过他们。但是我的英兄 Gopinath Acharya 认识他们每一个人。
So as he came closer, at that time then, Swarup Damodar and Govinda came there with many flower garlands and prasadam, and they were giving it to all the devotees.
那个时候呢，这个国王就看到。Swarup Damodar 和 Govinda 就是带来了很多的花环和 prasada 来迎接所有的奉献者们。
Lord Chaitanya had sent Swarup Damodar and Govinda to go there to give them flower garlands, to give them prasada. So the king said, Who are these two people?
是主 Chaitanya 派了这个 Swarup Damodar 和 Govinda 两个人去。带着花环和 prasada 去接待那些前来的奉献者们，
so,
然后这个国王就问这两个人是谁呢？
So of course these two they've been staying in Jagannath Puri, so Sarvabhauma knows who they are. He said this one is Swarup Damodar. He is like the expansion of the body of Lord Chaitanya.
因为呢，这两个人。他们两个人呢在库瑞待了一段时间，所以萨瓦巴玛巴塔查亚认识他们。萨瓦巴玛巴塔查亚就回答说呢，这一位是斯瓦鲁达姆达尔，斯瓦鲁达姆达尔就好比是主查坦尼亚躯体的第二个扩展。
Remember we said he was like a Gandharva with music, his musical ability was like a Gandharva.
还记得我们之前提到过这个。Swarup Damodar 他的这个才能就好像是这个歌仙一样，他非常擅长唱歌。
He's like a person from Gandharva Loka, the Gandharva means they're very good in singing and music.
他就好像是一个来自于 Gandharva Loka 的人。那就意味着他非常善于唱歌，非常这个精通音乐。
And in philosophy, he's like Brihaspati, the guru of the demigods.
而在哲学方面呢，他就好比是这个半神人的宁静导师 Brihaspati。
So he's really a great devotee, and he came. The other person with him is Govinda, and Govinda is Lord Chaitanya's personal servant.
所以呢，这个Swarup Damodar是一位非常好的奉献者，而在他旁边的呢是 Govinda. Govinda 是主 Chaitanya 的贴身仆人。
So they come. Swarup Damodar comes, and he first of all he garlands Advaita Acharya. And then Govinda comes and he also gives a garland to Advaita Acharya. So Advaita Acharya is honored first with two garlands.
所以呢，这个斯瓦鲁达玛达尔就向阿瑞塔阿查亚戴上了这个第一条花环，然后戈温达也向阿瑞塔阿查亚戴上了一条花环，所以说阿瑞塔阿查亚的脖子上呢就戴上了两条花环。
So Advaita Acharya, he's coming from Mayapur, so he knew Swarup Damodar because Swarup Damodar was also from Mayapur.
Advaita Acharya, 因为他是从 Mayapur 来的，所以他认识 Swarup Damodar, 因为 Swarup Damodar 也是从 Mayapur 来的。
But he didn't know Govinda, so he says to Swarup Damodar, "Who's he?" And Swarup Damodar said, "Oh, he was the servant of Ishwara Puri."
但是呢 ，Advaita Acharya 并不认识 Govinda, 所以他就问这个人是谁。然后苏瓦肉达姆达尔就告诉他这是 Govinda, Govinda 是 Ishwarapuri 的仆人。
And said he's very highly qualified. Ishwarapuri sent him here to serve Lord Chaitanya.
他说到呢，这位 Govinda 非常的有资格，是 Ishwarapuri 把他派来服务主查坦纳的。
So Lord Chaitanya keeps him always by his side.
主塔坦纳总是把他留在自己身边。
And the king, he's watching. He said, "Oh, who is this person? They give two garlands. Oh, who is this person? He's so effulgent. Oh, he looks like a great devotee. Who is he?"
这个国王，他就问到这个苏瓦肉达姆达尔和国温达把这个花环献给了谁？这位人物是谁呀？他看起来如此的这个，他的躯体，发出如此的光彩，他一定是一位伟大的奉献者。
Said, yes.
他是谁呀
？His name is Advaita Acharya, and he is honored by Lord Chaitanya. He is the topmost devotee.
然后 Govinda 的 Acharya 就回答说呢，他的名字是 Advaita Acharya。他甚至受到主塔坦纳的尊敬，他是最顶级的奉献者。
So then, so many other devotees all came: Srivas Pandit, Gadarhar Pandit, so many devotees all came, and they were all given garlands and prasadam, and the king was hearing their names, and the king was saying, "Wow, I've never seen so many effulgent devotees."
然后呢，当时有很多奉献者都来了，比如 Srivas, Gadadhar, 然后呢，这个国王就听说了这许许多多的奉献者的名字，这个国王呢就感到非常的惊奇，他就说道，我从来没有见到过如此光辉灿烂的奉献者们。
And then he sees,He says, "Oh, and the kirtan they're doing is so beautiful. I've never heard such a beautiful kirtan."
这个国王就说到呢，他们所做的这个所唱的这个kirtan简直是太优美了。我从来没有听到过如此，优美的这个kirtan的唱诵。
Yeah, their chanting is so melodious. It's so and they told the king. They said, "Yeah, this is."Prem Sankirtan. This is Sankirtan and love of God.
这个国王说呢，我从来没有听说过，从来没有听到过如此这个悦耳动听的 Kirtan。然后呢，他们就告诉这个国王，这个 Kirtan 叫做 Prem Sankirtan， 就是在对主的这个狂喜之爱中的唱诵。
And how they're dancing.Their dancing is so wonderful, and they're so effulgent. Oh, it's amazing. The king was amazed to see all these wonderful devotees.
而且他们的这个舞姿啊，简直是太这个优美了，而且他们的躯体都发出这种光辉灿烂。所以国王看到所有这些的时候，他感到非常的惊奇。
Of course, Lord Chaitanya came. to establish the chanting of the holy name, the Yuga Dharma.
当然了，主财参加降临就是为了建立这个年代的宗教原则。
Anybody who worships Lord Chaitanya by kirtan is very intelligent.
一个通过 kirtan 来崇拜主财参加的人是有智慧的人。
But people who worship demigods to get material benedictions, they're not intelligent.
而一个为了这个物质利益而崇拜半神人的人，被认为是没有智慧的。
So the king understands, he says, Lord Chaitanya is Krishna himself. Why are so many scholars not appreciating him?
所以这个国王就问道，主财参加马哈帕布是主 Krishna 本人，他是神本人，那为什么那些学者们并不接受这一点呢？
So Bhattacharya tells the king, you need to have mercy, you have to get the mercy from Lord Chaitanya to understand that he is Krishna.
所以巴达查亚就回答说呢，一个人必须得到主财参加的仁慈才能够理解。
The qualification is not material. Material qualification won't help you to understand Krishna.
这个资格呢，并不是物质的资格。物质的资格并不能够使一个人明白主台坦亚的身份是主 Krishna。
You don't get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya just by being a big scholar.
你不可能仅仅是一位学者。就能够得到主财参加的仁慈。
But then the king said, he said, oh, he said, they're not going in the temple. All the devotees are running to go and see Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Why are they not going in the temple first to see Lord Jagannath?
这国王就问道，这所有的这些奉献者们为什么都去见主财参加，而不首先去庙里呢？为什么他们不去庙里，而是去见主塔坦雅呢？
So they told the king, this is due to their spontaneous love. They're very anxious to meet Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
然后巴达查亚就告诉这个国王，因为这是奉献者们自发的爱，因为奉献者们都非常渴望。
And after they meet Lord Chaitanya, then they will take him to the temple to see Lord Jagannath.
当奉献者们见到主财参加之后，他们会带着他一起去见主 Jagannath.
So different devotees had been arranged to take prasadam, to bring them prasadam.
所以呢，有不同的奉献者们就去，做这个安排，给这些到来的奉献者们带来了 prasada。
The king was surprised. He said, "Oh, they're taking so much prasada, maha prasada. They're taking it to the residence of Lord Chaitanya. Why is this?"
国王呢就感到很惊讶，他就问道，为什么如此大量的 prasada 被带到了主财参加马哈帕布所住的地方？
He said, "Lord Chait."
他就想知道这是为什么。
The king surprised, he said, when people come to a holy place, there's some regulation they're supposed to follow.
这个国王呢感到很惊讶，因为这个当一个人来到这个朝政之地的时候，应该首先遵守一些规范原则。
When you come to a holy place, you're coming from an ordinary town or city orsome village or some, and then you come to a holy place. So first thing you should do is you're supposed to fast for the first night.
这个规范原则就是说，如果你是从一个普通的地方，就是从一个普通的城市或者村庄来到一个圣地的话，那这个你要遵守的规范原则就是第一个晚上你必须戒食。
And then they should also shave when they come to the holy place. Shave their head.
而且当一个人来到圣地的时候呢，他首先应该剃掉头发。
But the king said, look, they said they're going to eat prasadam. They're all eating prasadam.
但是国王说呢，你看看那些奉献者们，他们首先做的事情就是吃菩萨的。
So they told the king, said, yeah, that's right. According to regulative principles, there's one way that you're supposed to fast for the night, first night, and then break fast the next day. But there's another path, the path of spontaneous love.
巴达查亚呢就告诉国王，你所说的这个原则是对的，就是按照这个拜访圣地的规范原则的话，一个人应该在第一天晚上戒食，然后在第二天打破这个戒食，这是一条途径。但是呢，还有另外一条途径，那就是自发自爱的途径。
Just like you come to a holy place.They have to practice, they should observe complete celibacy.
就有一个规范原则说的是一个人到圣地之后他应该这个完全的遵守。
Before he comes to the holy place even, he should practice celibacy for some time.
甚至是在他进入这个朝圣之地之前他也要遵守一段时间。
But some people are so attached to sex that they cannot sleep at night if they don't have sex. Some people are so attached to sex, they must have sex. And if they don't get sex, they cannot go to sleep.
Oh, 就是有些人他非常的依附性生活，就是如果没有性生活的话，他在夜里甚至无法入睡。
But to go to the holy place, they're supposed to pray. They should be celibate for a week or before they come to the holy place.
但是如果他要去朝圣的话，他要去圣地的话，那么他在此之前的一周就要练习这个遵守。
And when he comes to the holy place, then fasting for the first day.
当他到了圣地之后呢，第一天晚上，第一天他应该戒食。
And then he should also shave his head clean.
而且呢，他也要把他的这个头发和胡须等等剃得很干净。
Just like when you go to Tirupati, you can see everybody shave their head.
如果你去这个 Tirupati 的话，你就会看到，人们会把他们的头发剃干净。
Men and women and children, all the family, everybody shave their head.
Oh, 无论是男人、女人，甚至是孩子，所有的家庭成员都会把这个头发剃干净。
And then after you, then they should take a bath in the river or in the ocean.
然后呢，你应该在这个河流或者是海洋里面沐浴。
So by doing these things, it destroys sinful reactions.
通过这么做呢，你就是在这个摧毁罪恶反应。
So going to a holy place is very good to get rid of sinful reactions.
所以去拜访圣地是一个人摆脱罪恶反应的很好的方式。
And this is why people like to come to a holy place. They want to get rid of their sinful reactions.
这就是为什么人们喜欢拜访圣地，他们想，就是摆脱他们的罪恶报应。
But that's for the ordinary people, because ordinary people are all sinful.
然而呢，这些规范原则都是针对普通人的，因为普通人一般来说是充满罪恶。
But when a devotee visits a holy place, a devotee, he doesn't have any sinful reactions.
然而当一位奉献者拜访圣地的时候，奉献者是没有罪恶报应的。
He doesn't do any sinful things. He's not engaging in any sinful activities.
奉献者并没有做什么罪恶的事情，因为奉献者并不从事罪恶活动。
So when he comes to the holy place,He purifies the holy place.
所以当这些奉献者们来到圣地的时候，他甚至能够净化圣地。
And he takes away the sinful reactions left by the ordinary people.
这些奉献者们来到圣地的时候，甚至会拿走那些普通人留在圣地的这些罪恶报应。
So there's a big difference between the ordinary man coming to the holy place and the devotees coming to the holy place.
所以这个普通人来到圣地和奉献者来到圣地是有很大的区别的。
So the 200 people who came from Bengal to see Lord Chaitanya, they were not ordinary people.
所以这两位不是，所以这两百名从孟加拉来的奉献者们都不是普通人。
And they don't have to follow the rules and regulations about visiting a holy place.
他们并不需要遵守这些拜访圣地的这些规范原则。
They just show their love for Lord Chaitanya.
他们只是表达出展示出了他们对主财坦雅的爱。
Immediately, they went to see Lord Chaitanya.
因此呢，他们直接就立即去见主财坦雅。
And Lord Chaitanya gave them prasadam, told them, eat.
主财坦雅给了他们菩萨达，告诉他们吃掉这些菩萨达。
Lord Chaitanya he didn't want them to follow all the rules and regulations about the holy place.
主财坦雅并没有要他们去遵守这些拜访圣地的这些规范原则。
So that order about shaving and fasting for the holy place, this is the indirect order of Krishna.
所以呢，这些规范原则就是，比如说戒食，还有剃头发等等，这些规范原则都是主 Krishna 的这个间接的教导。
But Lord Chaitanya telling them to take prasadam, this is a direct order.
当然呢，主财坦雅要他们吃 prasadam, 这是直接的训斥。
If there's no Mahaprasadam, then you can fast.
如果没有 Mahaprasada 的话，那你可以戒食。
But when Krishna personally gives Mahaprasadam, you have to take it.
然而，如果是 Krishna 给予了，直接给予了这个 Mahaprasada， 那你就应该接受。
If you don't take it, that's an offense.
如果你不接受的话，那才是冒犯。
If Lord Chaitanya is personally giving the prasadam with his hand, then you have to take it and you have to honor it. You have to take it. It's a blessing.
主财坦雅马哈帕布用他的手亲自派发了马哈普沙达。你应该去接受这个祝福。
If you want to fast, you must be crazy.
如果你想戒食的话，那你简直就是疯了。
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, one day Lord Chaitanya came to my house early in the morning, and he brought me Mahaprasadam.
这个 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢，他就说了一件事情，就是有一天，很早的时候，主财坦雅来到他的家里，给了他 Mahaprasadam。
Bhattacharya said, I had just got up from bed, I had not even washed my mouth, but I ate the prasadam he gave me immediately. And he was very pleased.
这个 Bhattacharya 就说到呢，我当时刚刚起床，甚至连嘴和脸都没有洗，但是呢，我直接就把这个主财坦雅马哈帕布给我的这个prasada立即就吃掉了，主财坦雅非常的满意。
So we take shelter of Lord Krishna, we don't take shelter of the rules and regulations.
所以我们是托庇于主 Krishna, 而不是托庇于这些规范原则。
Krishna's in our heart.
Krishna 在我们的心中。
He doesn't worry about all the rules and regulations.
他并不担心这些所谓的规范原则。
So the king was satisfied to hear all of these explanations.
当国王聆听到所有的这些解释之后，他感到非常的高兴。
So the king told all the people running the managing the temple of Jagannath Puri. He said, "You make nice arrangement for all these people. Give them whatever they want. Give them nice place, nice prasadam. Take care of them."
这个国王呢，就命令这个庙里的主管，他就命令这个主管为这些奉献者们安排很舒适的住处，给予他们菩萨的，无论他们需要什么，就提供给他什么，提供给他们什么。
Okay, so I think that's a good place to stop. Are there any questions?
现在就讲到这里，看看大家有没有问题。
那你衣服都没有吗？
是的，姑娘，那个福州的苏丽缇嘛，她有一个问题。他这个问题比较复杂，他说他有那个海默症，我也不懂这个病是个什么病。他说他现在脑袋不好使，没有办法，想问一下咕噜，他的海默症发展到什么都不知道的时候，如果家里人给他吃鱼肉蛋，他怎么办？就是第一个问，第二个，他说是否能在我有知觉的时候就进行觉识？那个时候，其实那个时候躯体就是个行尸走肉，没有一点意义。敬请咕噜批准我这样做好吗？顶拜咕噜的莲花足，只能求咕噜给我仁慈了。那个翻译，注意各位那边需要翻译。
OK， 这个玛拉吉叫什么名字？
苏尼提。
苏尼提。
苏尼提 ，OK， 苏尼提玛拉吉 is saying that she has some kind of disease, so she's very worried about that. When she lost her consciousness, if her family gives some meat or a fish egg for her to eat, what shall he do? What shall she do?
Well, I know this lady and I am familiar with her situation. I know her family and I know that she has a sister there. Her sister is also an initiated devotee, Suruchi. And Suruchi can certainly oversee and take care.
就是姑说他知道这位玛塔吉的情况，而且姑就是认识这位玛塔吉的家人。这位玛塔吉是不是有一位这个姐姐或者妹妹？然后他的这个姐姐是吗？然后他的姐姐可以照顾他。这个他的这个姐姐也是一位启迪的奉献者。
Also, there are other devotees nearby. So other devotees who are friends, they can also help.
这个附近呢也有一些奉献者，就是这些奉献者朋友们也应该去给予他一些帮助。
But her husband also knows that Suniti is a devotee and she follows a particular diet.
这个她的丈夫也知道这 Suniti Manaji 是遵守一些饮食规范的。
So although her husband is not really a vegetarian, but still he should arrange proper food for his wife.
虽然她的这个丈夫这个帕布并不是一位严格的素食者，但是呢他应该为他的妻子去安排一些素食的这个饭食。
So I don't think...
后面的。
后面呢？
The second...
你记得是吧？
大概吧。The second question is that Mataji wants to fast when she is in the proper consciousness. So she wants you to allow her to do this.
To do what?
Fast.
He said, 要请求Guru批准他这样做，好不好？这样做好吗？
这是多长时间？
直到死，他就说他有知觉的时候，他进行觉识，一直到死去，这样行不行？
Well, we'll wait and see at the time.
我们得等待这个时间。
We know, of course, we had Sankirtan Prabhu. Sankirtan Prabhu was here, and he had the cancer in the throat, so he was suffering a lot. He couldn't cure the disease, and he couldn't preach. So he took blessings from his guru that he could fast and give up his body.
我们知道这个桑克坦帕布他当时的这个喉咙得了这个癌症，他不能够治疗这个疾病，而且呢他也不能够去传教，所以呢他就向他的 guru 去寻求祝福，让他能够做这个戒食直到离开躯体。
So Sankirtan Prabhu did that and departed successfully.
所以桑克坦帕布他这样做的，他而且他是成功的做到了这一点。
But I don't think you have to worry about that yet. You still seem to be in good health.
但是呢，这个Guru说，你不用这个为这个事情担心，因为现在呢，你的身体状况还比较好。
That's something.You're not alone. You have a husband, you have family, so you have to make these decisions in consultation with them.
所以呢，因为呢，你不是独自一人，你还有家人，你有丈夫，所以你要跟他们商量一下。
Okay.
From Pancha Tattva, Prabhu, Dimbai Guru 和奉献者规范原则是根据具体的时间、地点、人物灵活安排吗？ The question is from Pancha Tattva, Prabhu, obeisances to Guru and the devotees. So the regulative principles, we should do the regulative principles according to specific time, place, and people, right?
Yes.
是的。
Regulations according to time, place, and circumstances, yeah.
这个规范原则是根据时间、地点、根据情况的不同来做出安排的。
We don't want to neglect rules and regulations. You know, we have to understand these devotees who came there to visit Lord Chaitanya, they're very advanced devotees.
当然了，我们不应该忽视规范原则，我们要知道那些前来与主台坦雅会面的那些奉献者都是非常崇高的、非常进步的奉献者。
So they were on that platform of spontaneous love for Krishna.
他们都是处在这种对 Krishna 的自发的爱的层面上。
They were very, they were, you know, so they were every day they're chanting the holy name, they're following all principles, regulated principles.
他们所有人每一天都唱诵主的圣名，并且遵守规范原则。
They were natural devotees.
他们是自然而然的奉献者。
So when they came to Jagannath Puri, they don't have to follow this rule and regulation.
所以当他们来到 Jagannath Puri 的时候，他们并不需要遵守这些规范守则。
Prabhupada didn't, he wasn't very strict about these kind of things with devotees.
虽然 Prabhupada对于这些规范原则就并不是很严格，就对奉献者们来说并不是很严格。
Things like fasting the first day when you come in the holy place and shaving the head. Of course you can do it, no harm to do it.
比如说这个当你来到圣地的第一天，你要戒食和剃头发等等。当然了，这些规范原则你也可以去做，这是没有问题的，你可以去遵守。
But if Lord Chaitanya is there and he's giving you Mahaprasadam, then definitely you want to take it.
但是呢，因为台坦雅马哈卡布他是亲自在那里，他是亲自给了你 Mahaprasadam, 那你就应该接受。The next question, Krishna Balaram Prabhu, invite Guru Maharaj, 觉悟 Krishna 有三步，第一凡的觉悟，第二超龄的觉悟，第三巴格瓦的觉悟。我们不知道凡是什么，也不知道超龄是什么，我们直接觉悟巴格瓦，我们直接从第三步开始觉悟 Krishna 可以吗？我们怎么从第三步开始觉悟 Krishna？ Obeisances to Guru Maharaj.So the realization has three steps. First is the realization of Brahman. Second, the realization of Super Soul. The third, the realization of Bhagavan. We do not know what Brahman is. We do not know what Super Soul is. We are directly realize the Bhagavan. Can we do that?And how can we begin to realize Krishna from the third step?
Well, yes, we can. We can realize Bhagavan. We don't have to separately realize Brahman and realize Paramatma. We can immediately go to Bhagavan realization.
是的，我们可以直接去觉悟八个万，我们不需要知道这个 Brahman 凡是什么，不需要知道这个 Super Soul 就是不知道这个超灵是什么。我们可以直接去觉悟这个八个万。
By doing Bhakti Yoga, we come to Bhagavan realization and we know Krishna.
通过从事这个奉献服务，我们可以直接觉悟八个万。我们可以直接这个觉悟 Krishna.
And we get knowledge about the Brahman and the Paramatma when we read the philosophy, when we read the Shastra. Just by reading Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam, there's a lot of information about the Brahman and Paramatma.
而且呢，我们也可以获得有关于 Brahman 和这个超灵的知识，通过阅读经典。有那么多的经典，比如《国家梵歌》，通过阅读这些经典，我们就会获得这些知识，了解到什么是 Brahman 梵，什么是超灵。
So some go step by step. They first realize Brahman, then they go on to realize part, then they, but that may take a very, very long time.
那有的人呢，他是逐步的这个觉悟的，他首先是觉悟什么是梵，然后去觉悟什么是超灵。
But,
但是呢，我们可以直接去觉悟 Krishna， 因为那样的觉悟，逐步的觉悟是很漫长的。
If we do bhakti yoga, then it's like going in the lift, that you go straight to the top.
如果我们从事 bhakti yoga， 我们从事这个 bhakti 瑜伽的话，就好比是你坐上的电梯，直接上升到 Krishna。
Yep.Just like there's a yoga ladder, there's a yoga ladder. You can go karma yoga, and then jnana yoga, and then dhyana yoga, and then bhakti yoga. It will take a long time.
比如说我们有这个瑜伽阶梯，你首先从 karma yoga， 从这个业报瑜伽一直来到这个 jnana 四遍有瑜伽，然后来到这个 dhyana yoga 冥想瑜伽，最终你来到 bhakti。Yoga, 这个凤爱瑜伽。
But if we just go straight to bhakti yoga, we can also realize all the other processes of yoga. It's all included within bhakti yoga.
但是如果你直接从事 bhakti yoga, 凤爱瑜伽的话，你也能够明白其他的这些瑜伽程序，因为所有的这些其他的瑜伽程序都已经包含在 bhakti yoga 里面了。
Karma yoga means working with detachment, so a devotee is also detached.
Karma yoga, 业报瑜伽意味着一个人，以不依附的这个心态去从事活动，奉献者们已经是不依附的了。
And then a devotee also has knowledge. And after karma yoga, jnana yoga, a devotee has knowledge because he's hearing about Krishna every day. He's hearing about Krishna's energies and Krishna's incarnations.
而在 Karma Yoga 之后呢，是这个 Jnana Yoga 知识瑜伽。而奉献者们呢，因为每天都在学习有关主 Krishna 的知识，所以这个奉献者们呢，也拥有这些知识，关于主 Krishna 的这些能量啊、化身啊等等这些知识。
And a devotee is also doing meditation because he's always remembering Krishna.
奉献者们也总是在进行冥想，因为奉献者们总是在忆念 Krishna.
So devotee doing bhakti yoga, it includes all the other yogas.
所以呢，一位从事 bhakti yoga 奉爱瑜伽的奉献者们，他已经就是已经在从事了其他的这些瑜伽体系，因为已经包含在其中了。
And same way, one devotee who is doing realizing Bhagavan realization, he also realizes the Brahman because he knows Krishna's energies everywhere.
同样的道理，一个觉悟了 Bhagavan 的这个人，他也同时觉悟到了什么是 Brahman 梵。因为他看到主 Krishna 的能量无处不在。
And he knows also Krishna's in the heart of all living entities, so that's Paramatma realization.
他也知道主 Krishna 在每一个人的心中，而这就是对超灵的觉悟。
Just like Prahlad Maharaj is the topmost devotee. So his father asked him, your God is everywhere. He asked Prahlad, where is your God? And Prahlad said, he's everywhere, father.
这个正如 Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj 呢是最顶级的奉献者。他的父亲就问他说，你说你的神无处不在，那你的神在哪里呢？这个 Prahlad Maharaj 就回答说，主无处不在，我的父亲。
So Prahlad Maharaj is not Paramatma realized, he's a Bhagavat devotee, very topmost devotee. But he knows Krishna's everywhere.
So Prahlad Maharaj, he is the most 顶级的奉献者, he is Bhagavat 奉献者. 但是呢，他知道主 Krishna 无处不在。
One who is the Kanista devotee, they only think Krishna is in the deity, but the more advanced devotee, they see Krishna everywhere.
这个 Kanista 初级的奉献者只能够在神像当中看到主，然而呢，一个更为进步的奉献者能够看到主无处不在。
So how do we realize Krishna? We simply by doing bhakti yoga, hearing and chanting.
我们如何去觉悟 Krishna 呢？我们只是通过这个 bhakti yoga, 痛爱瑜伽，通过聆听和唱诵。
If we hear nicely, then we will also repeat. We'll be able to chant nicely.
如果你很好的聆听的话，那你就能够很好的去重复。能够去唱诵。
And if we chant nicely, then we will also remember.
如果我们能够很好去唱诵，能够很好的去讲述的话，那么我们就能够去忆念。
So preaching and chanting is very important because when you chant, when you preach, then there's hearing and there's chanting, there's also remembering.
所以呢，我们去做这个传教是，去做这个讲述、去唱诵是很重要的。因为在你做传教的时候呢，在这个过程当中，你就能够去讲述，和意念。
So devotee is not missing anything. Everything is there in Krishna consciousness.
所以呢，奉献者们并没有遗失任何一项，这个所有的这一切都包含在 Krishna 知觉当中了。
We know the Brahman, we know Paramatma, and we also know Bhagavan.
我们理解 Brahman 梵，我们也理解 Paramatma 超灵，我们也理解Bhagavan 主 Krishna.
It's Krishna who attracts us.The Brahman doesn't attract us.
是主 Krishna 吸引我们，并不是这个 Brahman 吸引我们。
All right. Is there any other question there?
Yes. Last question. 金丽荣问：顶拜 Guru 和奉献者，请问当规范原则执行有反复的时候，我们应该如何弥补？执行有反复的时候，这个问题是什么意思呀？
我也不知道。
丁金荣
是他那个意思是这个规范原则没有遵循的那么好，有时候反复的，有时候没遵循，有时候遵循，这样反复要怎么样去弥补？
So for the regulative principles, sometimes.We can do it very well, but sometimes we cannot do it very well. So, how should we make up?
Well, how do we make up? The atonement, you know, just like you do something wrong, there's an atonement. So, what is the atonement for not keeping the regulative principles?The atonement is to keep the regulative principles.
所以有的时候呢，我们没有很好的去遵守这个规范原则，那应该如何去进行弥补呢？这个我们弥补的方式就是我们继续去遵守这个规范原则。
Yeah, we just have to try to go off, pick up from what you know, you go off track or you fall down.You have to pick yourself up and start again.
就比方说有的时候你跌倒呢，那你就得这个让你自己站起来，然后再次往前走。
But you have to be more careful and try not to fall down again.
但是呢，你得必须很小心，不要让你自己再次跌倒。
Try to keep the regulative principles. Understand it's important.
所以呢，你要努力的去遵守这个规范原则，你要知道这是很重要的。
So try to get good association.
嗯，你要尝试去获得良好的联谊。
And when we don't follow the rules and regulations, then we should regret, we should lament, we should feel very bad and fallen.
嗯，当我们没有能够去遵守规范原则的时候呢，我们应该为之感到忏悔啊，我们应该感到后悔，嗯，觉得自己很堕落。
Yeah, we shouldn't think, oh, it doesn't matter, or nobody follows anyway. Don't think like that. We should think, oh, it's not good. I should try to follow.
嗯，我们不应该觉得这没什么大不了的，反正别人也都没遵守。我们不应该这样去想。嗯，我们应该就是觉得，如果我们堕落的，那这是不好的。
We should think, I promised my spiritual teacher I would follow, I promised him I would chant, I promised him I would follow the principles.
嗯，我们应该想呢，我们已经向这个我们的灵性导师承诺了，我们要去遵守规范原则，我们要去念诵这个捐助，我们应该遵守我们对灵性导师的这个承诺。
Then Krishna helps us. When we really try to take shelter of Krishna and pray to Krishna to help us, Krishna will help.
嗯，所以如果我们真诚的想要达到 Krishna 的话，那 Krishna 会来帮助我们的。
We say, man proposes, God disposes.
嗯，sorry?
Man proposes, God disposes. Mo shi zai ren, chang shi zai tian.
Okay. Mo shi zai ren, chang shi zai tian.
So, yes, it's important for us, you know, that we're trying to make progress in spiritual life.Our progress depends on following the principles.
嗯，这对于我们来说是很重要的，啊，因为我们想要在灵性生活当中取得进步的话，那我们就要遵守这些规范原则。
But you know, you have to know sometimes some principles, just like we heard today, some things they didn't follow, but they were because there was a higher thing, a higher principle.Lord Chaitanya was giving prasadam. You should take prasadam.
嗯，但是有的时候呢，比方说我们今天所听到的，那些奉献者们呢，并没有遵守这个拜访圣地的这些通常的规范原则，而是遵循了更高的原则。因为呢，主凯坦亚马哈帕布给了他们prasadam，所以他们就遵守了这个更高的原则，就吃掉这个prasadam。
There's another pastime told in the Chaitanya Charitamrita about Lord Chaitanya's servant, Govinda. Govinda used to come every day to give Lord Chaitanya massage.
嗯，在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 当中呢，还记载了另外一个逍遥时光，就是关于主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这个贴身仆人 Govinda 的。就 Govinda 呢，通常每天都会去为主 Chaitanya 按摩。
So one day Lord Chaitanya was laying on the floor in the doorway of his room and Govinda could not get in.
有一天呢，这个主查泰亚马哈帕布就正躺在他的这个房间的入口处，Govinda 呢就无法进入房间。
Govinda asked Lord Chaitanya, can you move a little so that I can get in?Lord Chaitanya said, no, I can't move. I'm not going to move.
嗯，这个 Govinda 呢就向主提出请求说，您能不能往旁边挪一点，这样好让我进去。但是呢，主柴坦雅却说，我不能动，就我不能挪动自己的身体。
Govinda said, but you know, I just want to give you massage. He said, I have to get over there. I have to get over you, over your body.Or past your body in order to come there to give you the massage.
但是这个 Govinda 说呢，我得为你的身体进行这个按摩，所以呢，我不得不 从你的这个身体上跨过去，这样的话我才能够进去为你做这个按摩。
Lord Chaitanya said, well, it's up to you. You can say, if you want to come in, you can come in. If you don't, you can go.
这主禅丹雅就说到呢，那你自己决定吧。如果你想这样进来的话，那你就进来。如果你不想这么做的话，那你可以走。
So Govinda stepped over Lord Chaitanya's body and came in and gave Lord Chaitanya massage.
所以这个 Govinda 呢，他就跨过了主禅丹雅的身体，然后进入了房间为主做这个按摩。
And so that's no, that's not proper to step over the body of someone.
从一个人的身体上这样跨过去，这不是恰当的行为。
And Lord Chaitanya is Krishna, so it definitely is an offense to step over him.
而主 Chaitanya 呢，就是 Krishna， 如果从他的身上这样跨过去的话，肯定是一项冒犯。
But he came in to give him a massage.
但是 Govinda 进去只是为了给主做这个身体的按摩。
So he gave Lord Chaitanya massage, and then Lord Chaitanya was taking rest. He fell asleep. He was asleep for some time.
所以呢，这个 Govinda 就为主做这个身体的按摩。那主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就睡着了，他就睡了一会儿。
And after he woke up, he saw Govinda was still sitting there.
当他醒来的时候呢，他看到 Govinda 仍然坐在原处。
So Lord Chaitanya said, why are you still sitting there? He said, you were supposed to go and take your own prasadam. Why are you still sitting there?
这主 Chaitanya 就问 Govinda, 你为什么还坐在那儿？你应该去接受你的 prasadam, 你为什么还坐在这里呢？
But Govinda said, well, he said, I didn't want to step over you.
那 Govinda 就说我不想从你的身体上这样跨过去。
But Lord Chaitanya said, well, you stepped over me to come in. Why didn't you step over me to go out?
主禅丹雅就问他，既然你是跨着我的身体进来的，那你为什么不能跨着我的身体出去呢？
So Govinda said, well, I stepped over you to come in to give you service.But I can't step over you to just go and eat prasadam. That's not good. I said, for service, I can come over, I'd step over you, but not to go away.
这个 Govinda 就回答说呢，我进来的时候是因为我要为你做服务，而我现在不能就是这样跨着你的身体出去去吃prasadam。我进来的时候去是为了做服务，然而我出去的时候呢，并不是为了做服务，所以那是不恰当的。
So you have to be intelligent to understand when you can go against the rules and regulations.
所以呢，你应该有这个足够的智力去分辨，在什么样的情况下你可以不遵守规范原则。
Just like we do some things in our temple, we do Prabhupada's Guru Puja.And often we do it in front of the deities.
就比方说我们在庙宇里举行这个 Srila Prabhupada 的 Guru Puja 的时候，就是去崇拜 Srila Prabhupada 的时候，我们通常是在神像的面前进行崇拜的。
So we're not supposed to worship somebody in front of the deities, but Prabhupada allowed it.
本来呢，我们不应该在神像面前去崇拜某一个人。然而这是经过 Srila Prabhupada 允许的。
Because Prabhupada saw the mood of the devotees, the love of the devotees, that's more than the regulations.
Srila Prabhupada 就说到这个奉献者们的爱比这些规范原则更重要。
Okay, yes? Any other further question?
Yes.潘加塔德瓦帕布问，在达到 Ruti 的层面上，你才能够感受到 Krishna 的存在，否则一直在 Nista， 一直达到 Nista 的阶段，都是 Tauling 在帮助我们。其实当你发展出对 Krishna 的依附的时候， Krishna 能够感受到你对他的依附， 他会回应，然后你会感受到巴瓦。这是另外一位咕噜讲述的，对不对？So, it is at the level of Ruti that one feels the presence of Krishna. Otherwise, before the stage of Nista, it is the super soul who are helping us all the way. In fact, when you develop attachment to Krishna, Krishna will feel your attachment to him. He will respond. Then you will feel the bhava. So this is spoken by another guru. Is it right or not?
Yeah, it could be right. I don't see anything really wrong with that.
故事说他没有在这个陈述当中看到什么错误。
Yeah, we have to get through anatta nivritti and come to ruchi. Nishta, nishta, ruchi. Nishta, ruchi.
我们要通过这个 anatta nivritti 的阶段，然后到达 nista， 然后到达 ruchi 的阶段。
So, can you read it again? What happens after ruchi?
He's saying that before one reaches the nista, it is the super soul who are helping us, right?
Yeah, well,